Hello friends, welcome back. My name is Priyendra Kumar. In this video, you will learn how to create an automated and beautiful to-do list in Microsoft Excel. So as you are seeing my screen, I have created this beautiful to-do list. In this to-do list, you can capture your regular task as well as your ad hoc task. I'll show you here. This is your main screen wherein you will get your task which you have to complete. So here you can see the total pending task is 6 and the overdue is 5 and due for today is 1 and this is the all count which is 8. You can see a small check sign here over this 6 which means currently we are seeing the total pending. If I want to see the overdue task, you can just click on this box and then these are the 5 overdue tasks. If you want to see the task which is due for today, you can simply click on this box. And to see the all tasks, you can click on this. Alright, now I'll tell you about these buttons. This is for refresh. Now I'll show you the refresh also. Let's say I'm just going to click on due for today. Before showing this refresh button, I would like to show you the regular task list. Here is the regular task list or the task master. You can add your regular task and then you can fill this template. So let me add another task here, which is task 4. And this is, let's say, daily task. And I want to complete this task daily. You can put here yes on the day on which day this task to be completed. And let's say I don't want to do it on Saturday and Sunday. I'm adding another task which is task 5. And this is I'm making, let's say, monthly. In the monthly, I have to put the month date. You can put two dates of the month if it is twice in a month. Let's say I'm putting here 1st of month and 15th of month. Now we just have added two tasks, which is task 4 and task 5. So today is the 1st. So if I will refresh, this task should be added. And the day is Friday, so this task 4 should be added also. If I will go to to-do list and I will refresh this, then you can see. Now, 3 tasks are due for today. These are task 1, task 4 and task 5. The next button is to add the ad hoc task. If there is a ad hoc task which is not available in this regular task, if you want to add the ad hoc task, so you can simply click on this plus button. Then this small form will be popped up and here you can put your task name. Let's say I'm just putting some dummy name, ad hoc task 1, and you can put the action date. By default it will be today's date. You can change this date using the calendar, so just click on this calendar button. This calendar form will be popped up. You can select any date here, or you can move the next month and previous month or whatever you want to do. So let's say here I'm selecting 5th November and just click on add. Okay, that task has been added, but it is not displaying here just because we have filtered our data for due for today. So we have taken the action date as 5th November. If I will click on all, that will be visible. So this is the ad hoc task which we have just added. Now I'll show you how can you update a task. So let's say I want to update these tasks. So these 3 tasks I have completed. Now I want to mark it as done or completed. Select the task name in this column and click on this update button. And here you can change the status as completed, which is already there, or you can change the status also if required. You can put your comments here. Task has been completed and click on update button. Now you can see we have updated these tasks. So we have updated all the tasks for 1st of November, which is today. You can see we have selected all tasks and there is no other task is available for 1st November. That is the reason due for today is 0. So if you will click here, then you will not see any task. You can see the overdue or the total pending. So total pending is 6. 1 is pending for 5th of November, which is the future dated. That is how you can use this. If you want to delete any task, if you feel this task should not be here, you can select that task or multiple tasks and you can simply go to this delete button and just click here. those tasks will be deleted. Now I'll show you the database of this to-do list. Just right click and unhide. You can see the database sheet is here. So this is the database. At the month end or whenever you require, you can copy your tasks and you can create a report. Alright friends. Now I'll tell you how I have created this automated to-do list. So first of all, I would like to show you the support sheet here. So just unhide another sheet, which is the support sheet. This is the support sheet. First of all, I have created the database sheet. So this is the database sheet. This is the simple serial number, task name, due date, status and the comments and the timestamp column. At the last, there is a ID column. This ID column is basically the combination of due date and task name. You can see B2 and C2. One task name should be once only for that particular day. It should not be repeated. Alright, so that is the reason we have used this ID. It is automatically generated by the VVA and you don't need to create this. We have used the simple Excel formula. So we have created this simple database table first. Then we have created the support sheet. I'll show you the support sheet. This is the support sheet and we have created this simple box using these three rows. I'll show you. I have merged these two and then I just have changed the border. So just right click, go to the format cells. Here I have gone to the borders. Then I have taken this double border like this. Then I have filled here some light color, let's say this one. Then here I have filled some dark color, this. Alright, so I have created these three boxes like this. Then you can see I have put some formula. This is total pending and this is the formula. You can see the countif formula from database sheet. So this is simple countif formula from database sheet from column D. This is the column D, which is status. I'm just counting pending. Then for the overdue is basically the status should be pending. You can see I have used the countifs and another condition I have taken from the C2C of database sheet, which is the due date. So due date should be less than today. Alright, so if due date is the past date, that means it is overdue, or due date is before today, that means that is overdue and status is pending. Now this is due for today. Here we have used database D2D column, which is the status, and again we are counting for pending, but this time the condition we are taking equal to today means if the status is pending and due date is today, then it will give you the count here. Then at the last we have taken all. For the all we just have used the count for D2D, the status column. And here we have used minus one because when we will use the count, then it will count the header also. So we are just removing one from that. Now here you can see using the macro, we are changing the value on this I3. If we will click on total pending, then what will happen? Here macro will write the total pending. And on this cell, we have used this check sign. I will explain you why I have used this and how to use this check sign. Since we have just clicked on total pending there, then this is checked. What formula we have put there? We just have put if I3, this is the I3 value is equal to C5, this one, then it will display 1, otherwise it will display blank. Similarly, here we have used if this I3, this value is equal to this value, which is overdue, you can see here, then it will display 1, otherwise it will display blank. And similarly here and here also. And this value will be changed when we will click on any box here. Let's say here I'm just clicking, then the value should be overdue there. You can see this is the overdue. We have put the conditional formatting on each cell. I'll show you here. Press Alt OD to open the rule manager. Click on edit rule. And you can see we have taken the icon set here, and here we have take this check sign when the value is equal to or greater than 1, and for 0 or less than 0 we just have taken cross sign. But if you will see in the formula, there will not come 0, it will come 1, otherwise it will come blank. So whenever it will come 1, it will display that check sign, and this will come 1 only, that box will be clicked. Now I'll tell you how I have created these boxes. Just go to the support sheet, copy this, Ctrl C, and you can paste as linked picture here. Since this is protected, so let me unprotect this first. You go to the review and I have not put any protection password, just unprotect this. Now copy this again, go to to-do list, go to home, paste a special, and you can use this linked picture. You can see these are the linked pictures. So whatever box or the value will be available there, that will come here also. Alright friends, so when we are going to copy, we are copying from here. Copy and go to the paste a special linked picture. If I will click here, then you can see the checksign here and here also. Alright. Let me unprotect and delete this. And then we have pasted four images here, these buttons. So we have assigned some macro on these buttons and we have assigned some macro on these four linked pictures also. I would like to tell you about the regular task list. So this is the regular task list. As I have explained you, you can add your new task here. You can select the frequency. If the frequency is weekly or daily, then you just need to select the days. If it is monthly, then I have given the option to put 2 days of the month. You can put any 2 days or you can keep just one date only. Another date you can keep the blank. Alright, so on that particular day, whenever you will refresh, the task will be added to the list automatically. Now I will tell you how I have created this drop down with the conditional formatting. So here I have taken right click, go to the unhide, and you can see I have taken here yes and no, but this is not the yes and no. Let me copy and paste a special value here. You can see actually this is the 1 and 0. And here what I have done, just press Alt OE to open the format cells, go to the number, and you can see the number formatting I have used yes, semicolon, no, semicolon, no. So basically for 0 I want to display no and for 1 I want to display 1. However, if you will look at the formula bar, it will be available 1 and 0. Then we have used the data validation here with this link. So press Alt DL, then you can see this is the data validation list. So once 1 and 0 will be available here, or you can see here this is 1, you can see here this is 0. Then we have put the conditional formatting. So let me press Alt OD. This is the icon set conditional formatting. Click on edit rule. Here you can see this is the check for the value is greater than 1 or equal to 1, and cross for 0 or less than 0. And here we have just checked the show icon only. So it is just displaying the icons only. Alright friends, so that is how we have created this template. And here we have created simple drop down for daily, weekly and monthly. Let me show you this one also. This is daily, weekly and monthly. So friends, that is how we have created the regular task list. Now I will tell you how I have created this table. So just go to the view, you can check the headings. So these are the headings. This is the simple table we just have formatted. To format the header, what we have done, so just go to the format cell, press Alt OE, and here we have taken the fill color with the fill effects, and we have taken the first color is this, second color is this, and then we have taken this variant, this one. Alright, and here to create the border, we just have used simple border. Just press Alt OE, go to the borders, and we have taken this color for the border color and this line style, and we just have click here, here and here. We have not taken any vertical line like this. Alright, so this is the border style. So friends, that is how we have created this sheet. Now I will explain you in the next part of this video whatever macro coding I have used. So I'll show you, I have created multiple macros here and I have created these 2-3 forms also. I'll explain you in the next part of this video. Please watch the next part of this video. Thank you so much for watching.